子时，自然由大门离去。如果此门无法开启，而被迫从窗户或阳台跳出时，就可能会摔断腿。我们的肉体就像一间房子，真我灵性就像是房子的主人。当有一天肉体要毁坏时，真我灵性若不得正门而出，被迫另寻旁门，其恐惧与焦虑是无法形容的，这也导致了死后的痛苦与不安。因此，我们可以发现到，绝大多数的人临终时，其肉体皆显现山僵硬、恐惧无助与挣扎之相。求道就是开启我们的生来死去之正门，也就是通天大路。因此，我们今天很幸运能求道，求得三宝，打开灵性通天之正门，可以让我们找回真我，认识我自己身上的道，自然以良心作为待人物之准则，使人生更有意义，更进而解决生死大事，得到超生了死的保障。百年之后，回到我们的来故家乡，所以先天大道又是回天之道。先天大道之宝贵，即是千经万典不如一点，此点打开玄关正门佛门，天堂大路一步直超级的永生之道。此点宝贵，超佛越祖，超经越点，超越天地。得到这一点宝贵，它是诸经之师、诸法之王、诸佛之天地之，故曰超生了死即的永生不毁不灭之先天大道也。此乃即是人人原来固有的，必须返回天之道也。四求道对我有什么好处？我们今天很高兴能有个机缘求道，能够开启良心之门、智慧之门、通天之正门，这是第一步。这宝贵的道还能带给我们终生受用不尽的福之意，离苦得乐，人生在世遭受种种之苦恼，就其根源皆起因于迷失了真我。求道首先就是让我们认识人人身上固有的道，找回我们本有至真至善至美具足圆满永恒不休的真我，在日常言行之中发挥真我，使我们一举一动皆能合于理，止于至善，自然不会受周遭的人事物所左右，我们的心也就不会患得患失。心为一身之主，我们既然在心境上有所提升，自然不会与邪恶之事相感应，则不相随心转，还可以改变命运，趋吉避凶，朝向光明，使我们得到真正的喜悦、逍遥自在。二堕彼难，自有人类文明以来，道的真意便代代单传独守，其没落贯穿了早期的主要文明，如中国、印度等。奈何近百年来人类受物欲所逼， 在空前繁荣的物质文明中逐渐迷昧了良心。甚至竞相制造威力极大的杀人武器。回顾数千年人类历史，在近代短短数十年间，便发生了两次世界大战，无数挑战，伤亡无数。滥用科技文明，同时也损害了自然环境，造成大气臭氧层之破坏，全球性气候的改变，人心之变，但造了天灾人祸连连。人类已为自己酝酿了一个空前的浩劫，因此上帝洪恩慈悲，特将大道普传于此，以挽救良善。求道以后，我们时刻存着道心，以良心待人处事。当遇有人力不可挽救的灾祸时，只要诚心使用三宝，必能灾必劫，逢凶化吉。此事验证甚多，不胜枚举。三超生了四人生，又如一段苦乐相参的旅程，遭受生存竞争、衰老、病痛、死亡等困苦，人皆难免。而人间种种欢乐又往往是短暂易变的，尤其当旅程结束时，终就成空，归宿渺茫，更不禁令人凄独怅惘。是以智慧者有见于此，乃以超生了死，追求真实永恒的人生意义，为人生至高之目标。古代先修后的，因此古人为求超生了死，尽毕生之力苦修苦行，仍难以访得名师达成心愿。如今大道普传，先走后修，在求道过程中，天命名师一指，开启了我们通天正门，先赋予超生了死的保障。我们得道以后，认识了真我，以真我为主宰，远离邪心妄念，让我们的心念、言语、行为，无论待人处事，皆合于良知。百年之后，真我灵性自然返回故家乡，永享平安喜乐。四成圣成贤求道，也就是为我们种下一个成圣成贤的正因道种。只要我们以智慧、慈悲心尽灌溉它，它必然萌芽、开花、结果。在此功利主义弥漫的黑暗时代，大道乃是光明的灯塔。求道修道，不仅让我们能够独善其身，更是我们有机会可以兼善天下。求道之后，只要我们时刻抱着道心、良心，在日常生活中真诚实践道的精神，不计个人得失荣辱，努力使周围每一个人都可得享道的好处，让道的光明照亮每一个角落，尽其一生精进不懈，则在此即成就圣贤事业。归天之后，必证圣贤果位无疑。先天大道的宝贵就是天道天命，天命就是三曹名师，名师一点玄关开，打开正门佛祖来。 天堂飞在我身外，天上地下我都在。此乃先天大道的尊至贵至宝也。先天大道，天命宝贵，三朝名师这一点妙至极矣。非是在言语文字相生应可得，非是在千经万典上的，非是在讲经说法上的，非是在是指变聪上的，非是在博学才能上的，非是在才高八斗上的，以上皆是生死法对待法，非是超生了死脱对待了生死之法也。此次级的先天大道妙用妙能的宝贵，其妙极矣。此者是无师智，此智是妙智妙慧，此智此慧是我本来固有的，由先天带来的，以及是在找回来天地人万物万类未生以前我的初心，即我良心天心道心老心也。先天大道之妙，此妙之贵，妙不容言，不学而知，不学而能，亦即是先天带来的先知先觉妙用妙能，此知此觉此能此用，不用言语文字声色，不用思想，不用念头，不用言听是动，而生天地人万物万类，生天地人万物万类之后，这天地人万物万类时可分妙，也离不开其妙用妙能，故曰万灵真主宰也。设若天离开先天大道之妙用妙能，则河汉星斗乱序，日月无光，亦不能轮转，则阴阳二气不能流通，万物万类世界的众生，人人皆不得其生存。设若大地离开先天大道之妙用妙能，这金木水火土不能相配，则险象丛生，山崩地裂，海水枯干，亦使万物万类世界的众生人人不能得其生存。设若人离开先天大道之妙用妙能，则寸步难行，眼不能看，耳不能听，口不能言，总之全身不能动作，一百日之后成了一堆臭骨臭泥土。此乃先天大道妙用妙能的宝贵，妙至极矣。设若觉悟认识先天大道之妙用妙能的支持而实行，即是天人合以天人一体治理，觉言妙不容言，不是死后成佛，当体即佛矣。故曰如来佛如是佛也。此乃的先天大道修先天大道之好处，物具备什么条件才可以求道，求道既然能够带给我们终生受用不尽的好处，我们今日能有机会求道，会不会显得太容易了？事实上，我们能得闻先天大道，首先要感谢上帝的恩慈，将自古不兴泄的大道普传于此，使我们有机会得此天之道。另一方面，我们本身也必须具备足够的条件，祖上有德，根基深厚，佛缘成熟。 才能够顺利求道。此外，我们必须向宇宙至高无上的造物主上帝发一个良心愿。此愿可归纳为三个要点：一、得道以后，愿以铭记并实践道的精神，也就是日常生活所思所言所行，皆愿以良心作为依归。二、得道以后，愿以能力所及，助周围需要我们帮助的人，愿意多了解道的意义，并让更多的人蒙受天道的福祉。三、得道以后，绝不将求得的三宝告知任何人。三宝必须在庄严的求道过程中，天命名师传授给我们才有真实意义。若由我们泄露给其他人，则不但毫无意义、毫无效果，我们自己也违反了天律。的良心愿合乎人人本具天赋的良知良能，所以我们人人都能够做到。真诚实践良心愿，也必须滋润我们求道时种下的智慧、慈悲、清净之正因道种，使它顺利萌芽、开花、结果，才不至虚度这千载难逢的求道修道良辰。值得一提的是，我们能顺利求道，原因之一即是沾了祖德的光，是故上天开恩，只要我们修道有恒，则我们的祖先也有机会可以求道超生得救，我们的子孙亦得应地，对父母祖先敬大小，这是最好的机会。只要具备以上条件，则不论任何国界、种族、宗教信仰的人都可以求道。欲求得先天大道，脱出轮回之苦、地狱之灾、世间的穷通受忧、鳏寡孤独、生老病死苦，而返天堂永享天伦之乐者，必须我有得遇六万年良辰佳期的幸运。我本人心地善良，我有先天根基深厚，也就是我本人前世做的功德善事很多，此即天缘。我本人祖先有功德做善事，此即祖上有德。我目人遇到银宝师度我得道，此佛缘已至，也就是前生我们一同做过功德善事，或一同有修过宗教，今生遇天道降世，一同得道修道，此乃佛缘已至。六、求道对我的生活有什么影响？现今正值上天恩开，先天大道普传，拯救良善之时，故普传方式皆以方便善巧与众生契机为原则，因此求道不会对我们正常的生活造成任何负面影响。这与以往许多人苦修苦练，甚至出家的修行方式有很大差别。也正因为如此，先天大道能在日新月异的现代，适应社会的各个阶层，传布到世界的各个角落，使人人皆有共沾天恩的闻大道的机会。 关于求道对生活有什么影响？我们又以下几点来看，亦与任何宗教没有冲突。道代表着天地万物及我们一生之最高主宰与真理，不止在各大门创始之前，甚至在天地未生以前，道就已经存在了。因此，任何教门，只要其教义是追求真理及实践良心，就不会与道有任何冲突。事实上，不止宗教，只要我们以探求真理的角度去观察，则自然界万事万物皆能与道吻合与印证。若我们原有某种宗教信仰，求道将不会造成任何抵触，也不会使我们背弃原有的信仰，反而让我们对真理的探求有更深一层的体认。二，以良心经为最高规戒，每一个人生活环境中的文化习俗、时代背景、法律条文及价值观念都不完全相同，因此没有任何一个具体的规戒或条文能够适用于所有的人。所以求道后的规戒着重在我们每个人真我良心之实践，由真我良心主宰自己，而不是在经典之背诵上及律法之钻研上下功夫。三，不照良心愿行，有何后果？很重要的一点，求道并非从外在加给我们良心与真理，而是借着开启我们智慧慈悲之门，找回我们身上固有的真理，让天理良心自然流露。因此求道后，所有真修实行之人皆是自动自发的。师父，求道后若我们不照良心愿而行，并非将出现任何外力来强制我们遵行此愿，而是将受到自己良心的谴责，由真我良心督促自己而自然改过向善。四，圣凡间修真我之实践，并不局限于教堂或寺庙之中。因此，现今大道普传，并不要我们家舍业到深山古寺之中修炼，而是在不影响家庭工作学业之正常情况下圣凡兼修。在日常生活中，时时刻刻一言一行皆能以天理良心为依归，就是真我之实践，务由提升自己而兼善天下。求道后会使我们生活更充实，心灵更和谐，而更重要的是，我们每一个人尽一己之力，借自身之提升影响周遭之人事物，继而汇成一股力量，在这举世天理良心日趋沦丧之潮流中，匡正人心，力挽狂澜，如此必能早日实现先天大道普传之宗旨及弥勒佛的仁慈大愿，化污泽的人间为人间净土，化纷乱的世界为世间天国。七，道的宝贵有什么印证？道是宇宙的至高真理， 它的作用贯穿了天地万物万类，更是我们一生之最高主宰。真正了解了这一点，我们就会体认到，道是随时随处可以被印证的。许多贤贤得道之后，发出了大诚心、大信心、大智慧，真修真行，皆能参悟道。不止在各教经典之中可以印证道，其实在任何时间空间，万事万物，我们之一身，甚至一草一木，皆离不开道的本体和妙用。体认至此，自然能发出永不退转之道心。而尚未求道或刚求道者，则需借助于一些具有形象看得到、感受得到的印证，以奠定初步的信心。依任何人，只要有求道，经过深淡天命之名师点开玄关正门，传授三宝者，无论其功德高深为末，死后皆是身软如棉，面色如生，灵性由正门归天，冬不品湿，夏不腐臭，甚有多至数日不变，一相满世者。目前的科技文明和医学知识还未进步到足以解释这种现象，但却无法否认各事实的存在。这种现象虽曾出现在某些宗教中，但极其罕见而珍贵。而求道之人，除信道不笃于反道败德者，不敢定论外，其余则比比皆是。肉身既显自瑞香，足可证其灵性已登善境，当无疑问。二人虽不为万物之灵，其实是很脆弱的。自从生在这个世界上，就难免天灾人祸的威胁。甚多以求道者，在遇到人力不可挽救之危急情况下，诚心使用三宝，皆能大事化小，小事化无。这种例证多得不可胜数，无法在此一一例举。以上两点虽然极为宝贵，但却是任何人只要一求道，借着上帝的天命宝贵，立刻就可以得到的保障。此后就随个人的诚心智慧及对真理之实践，而有或深或浅不同的体认了。如人饮水，冷暖自知。希望各位具有善根，有机会能得闻大道的先生女士，皆能入宝山而满载而归，皆能求道而弘真善境。
Introduction to DAYI. What is DAYI? DAYI. What it is in DAYB. What do I get in RECIB? Ending DAOB. What do we need to receive DAOBI?What impact does receiving DAO have on MEBII? What can attest the validity of DAOI? What is DAO observing the cosmos and all the living beings consciously, among all the earthly activities and phenomena? We will find the existence of the laws of nature.There is a supernatural origin which guides all the operations happening across the galaxy, the Earth, and the human beings. We call this source Tao. Tao existed before primordial time, and even before the universe was merged. It is the origin of the world, and it thereafter nurtures all the creatures and beings. Since it is unchangeable and does not evolve with time, it is the ultimate truth. It is what all saints and sages throughout human history had been searching for. The essence of Tao is the foundation of nature. The law or the power that existed before the universe was formed is beyond description, because there were no civilizations nor creatures, let alone languages. Since it cannot be applied any name, we simply call it Tao. After the world was merged, along with the mutations of the universe, we see the harmonious actions as exhibited in seasonal changes, rhythms of time and tide, and the balance of the ecosystem. We also find some conformity of human nature across various cultures. These prove the laws of nature. This is the extension of that original Tao when it is substantiated and materialized. It merged into everything that is with and within us. Now that we know Tao is present universally and yet difficult to be recognized, there had been prophets and preachers trying to make us know and understand the origin and the truth of life through various teachings and literature since the beginning of civilization. They were scattered around the world throughout history. As a result, great commandments were taught to disciples, and goodness and badness were differentiated. These teachings varied, based on differences in culture, background, timing, and the level of each individual's comprehension. However, they all tried to express and transmit to their descendants this creator and chief of the universe. It is God, or what we call Tao. As we get to know it more and more, we will realize that the essence of Tao and its effect covers every existence without any exceptions. Tao is actually the headwaters of all religions. It embraces the essence of all the preaching and teachings. And yet, it is superior to the system of belief. It is the nature, the universe itself. Tao or God represents the highest authority and power of nature. It is also the headstream and superior to all. It is the unchangeable principle. Understanding Tao allows us not only to discover the center of all religious belief, but also to communicate with the origin and the highest power of nature. We will then be able to relate ourselves to the truth of the universe. To probe further, Tao existed before the formation of all, yet it was not anterior, which means that the creation was embedded in it. Tao emerges into the creation, yet is not posterior, which means that it is not thereafter limited. Among those created, however large, they can be measured; however small, they can be detected. It is only Tao that cannot be measured of its immensity nor detected of its existence. Therefore, it is larger than the largest and leaves nothing excluded, and yet it can be smaller than the smallest and leaves nothing not penetrated. It is ubiquitous. It merges into and governs all. It is in charge of the space, the earth, human beings, all the creatures, and all existences. It penetrates and regulates the entire universe. It is the source of all the scriptures, sutras, as well as dharmas. It encompasses all the religions, and it is what makes one a Buddha or a saint. It is the single chief of all. And, above all, it is in charge of each individual too. It is the divine self. This is the true meaning of Tao. We should get to know it this way and rediscover our own invaluable treasure. So, to practice Tao is to revive one's own conscience as well as everyone else's and to act upon it accordingly. Then, all people can be of one spirit, all nations can be in peace like a family, and the great harmony will come true. How precious Tao is! Dao and me, the significance of Tao is in its immensity and ubiquity. Its mightiness guides the universe to carry on with changing seasons and evolving creatures. The countless aspects of the natural phenomena seem so capricious and yet really in order and in cycles. This almighty being also resides in each of us. It is the divine self, the natural quality of a person. It enables us to see, to feel, to taste, to hear, and to move without learning. While we research the ultimate truth in the universe, we should turn in upon and see into ourselves to discover that divine self. We will find the rules that govern the universe also comply with the way we are. Tao is not something too far to reach, nor too mysterious to comprehend. It is nothing particular, but has to do with our daily lives. We cannot do without it. Every movement we make, in order to see, to touch, to feel and to think, is associated with Tao. Consider how many wonders are hidden in our body, how delicately our physical functions are carried out. For example, when we shake hands, the components involved would include the coordination of joints and muscles, the chemical reactions of energy, the transmission of information through nerve systems, and the actions occurring in our brain such as issuing orders, making judgments and analyzing situations. Even with the most advanced technology and the highest level of knowledge we have developed today, we cannot completely reconstruct such a function. Yet the ability to perform such a simple movement is there for all individuals, regardless of the level of a person's knowledge and his/her being a grown-up or a baby, a scholar or an illiterate. Theses are the kind of abilities we come equipped with naturally, without learning and being taught. It sits within us and is in charge of all. It is Tao, never diminishes nor inflates. Worldly knowledge acquired through learning can be forgotten. A gymnast can abandon his/her techniques and a musician can lose his/her skills without practicing. The essence of Tao and its extension are always in charge of the macro universe, the nature, and the micro-universe the human being as self. We are associated with it unconsciously since the first day, because it encompasses the whole nature within us. We also call it native self. Tao is within and surrounding us. It needs not be worshipped nor debated over, because its existence is unconditional, regardless of race, color, nationality, religion or status. It is impartial and stays constant. In receiving Tao, we not only find the origin of the universe, but also the divine self. We get to know the highest power in the universe as well as the genuine nature in charge itself. We discover the ultimate truth of the cosmos as well as the integrity of ourselves. Recognizing that the laws which govern the universe also govern us makes us be able to return to our true nature. To probe further, the most essential concept in Tao is that we all possess it intrinsically. It is the wisdom and ability we were born with without learning or practicing. It is one as conscience, which is like the spirit of God, the divine and immortal nature. It is invisible and intangible. For this reason, we call it genuine emptiness, which means that to be really empty, it goes beyond emptiness and can therefore have marvelous existence in it. Marvelous existence is the foundation for the sky, the earth, human beings, all the creatures, and all existences. With omnipotence, Tao is called Great Lord of all beings. This almighty being is not only in charge of the entire universe, but also in charge of oneself. So the proverb is, Tao is within self, which is the drive of all one's abilities. A physical body without Tao is useless. This is the treasure that we should all realize and fully explore. What it is in Tao. When we look around the world, we admire the miracles and wonders of nature. Countless things change and move simultaneously every second, and yet in order and in harmony. So do our bodies. Countless biochemical reactions and physical functions occur concurrently within our bodies. Without learning and thinking that come subjectively, the thousands of activities that happen within us are the extension and action of Tao. And altogether, it is one single self. It functions naturally and automatically without the need for our intents to be involved. This is the effect of Tao within us. Tao is not only in control of the universe and nature, but also in charge of every human being in his/her own actions. In other words, it is the same source that governs us as well as everything else. Tao is invisible and intangible, but it has been working out its magic before day one. Thereafter, languages, cultures, religious scriptures, literature, and civilization were developed. They all originate from Tao functioning within us. People don't realize it is Tao that has been residing and working within us and have used soul to represent the confusing and yet irrefutable being. Because it is eternal and intangible, we also call it true self. This true self is the most abundant, brilliant, and imperishable being. Let us take a look at our tangible body and see if it can be the true self. We know the pictures taken throughout one's life show different faces and expressions. We recognize people by face, but our looks change and are not permanent. The handicapped, with impaired arms or legs, can also lead a complete life. One with a transplanted animal heart is still a human being. Even our brain cells keep decreasing and changing every second from the moment we were born. Therefore, the physical body is only the interim residence of the true self. Though it seems so real, solid and alive, it turns into dirt eventually. We call it false self because of its tentative and transient nature. By recognizing the difference between the true self and the false self, we understand the reason and importance for us to receive Tao. Luckily, we are given the opportunity of receiving Tao and learning the three treasures. The three treasures are straightforward yet profound. The meaning and details of them will be illustrated through the rite of receiving Tao. Here, we only discuss two issues. First, by receiving Tao, the true self gets plumped out. It leads to our conscience. Upon the time when material pursuance surpasses spiritual seeking, giving up the true self only makes us a walking corpse. In order to fulfill and satisfy the sensational desires of the false self, we may commit wrongdoings and harm others, eventually creating troubles for ourselves. Our inner conscience is identified and enlightened by receiving Tao. Thus, the body gets to work with the spirit in a mutually beneficial and harmonious way, making our lives joyful and meaningful. Second, by receiving Tao, the front door or main gate of our bodies gets opened. It leads us to conscience, mercy and wisdom. When we leave a house, we leave through the front door. If the front door is locked, we may have to leave through the back door, or even by breaking the window or jumping off the balcony. We may fall and get hurt by doing so. Our body is like a house, and our soul is the master who lives in the house. One day, when the body is aged and depleted and the soul has to leave, we can imagine its horror if it cannot leave through the correct exit. This is the pain and discomfort human beings experience at the coming of death and after death. As we know, for most people, when they are dying, their body shows stiffness and signs of helplessness and confusion. After we receive Tao, the door of life and death will be opened. Being able to receive Tao and the three treasures while having the door to heaven opened, we had the opportunity to recognize the true self and the Tao that dwells within us. We are going to treat people and the world with conscience and make our lives more meaningful. We can transcend life and death. Within 100 years, we will be able to return to where we came from. Therefore, The heavenly bow is also the way to a return back to heaven. To probe further, the enlightenment of Tao is superior to studying thousands of sutras. This is the value of Tao. The enlightenment of Tao opens the main gate, the front door, which is the entrance to heaven. It gives us the guarantee to be exempted from rebirth cycles and to reach eternity. The superiority of this enlightenment lies in that it surpasses Buddhas and saints, it exceeds the scope of sutras and dharmas, and it transcends the universe. Tao is therefore source of all sutras, king of all dharmas, mother of all Buddhas, and creator of the universe. Transcendence of rebirth cycles leads to eternity. Being imperishable, Tao never deteriorates, and we have never lost it at all. Hence Tao is the direct way back to heaven. What do I get in receiving and Dao as mentioned earlier, by receiving Tao? We act upon our conscience, gain more wisdom, and find the door to heaven. In addition to these basics, we also benefit from the following for our lifetime. A. Being away from sufferings and closer to happiness. The troubles and worries we face in our daily lives mostly result from our disregard of the true self. Receiving Tao helps us to recognize the Tao that has been dwelling in us and to restore the beauty of the true self, so that our behavior and mind is free from being controlled by the earthly pleasures and being swayed by the losses and gains of the material world. Since our minds are cultivated spiritually, devils would not approach and get close to us. Thus, our fortune can be altered from bad to bright, and we can obtain real joy. B. Being away from disaster and calamities. Tao has been passed on through generations to one single master since the beginning of human history. The thread of its passage weaves through ancient civilizations, including China and India. However, in recent centuries, human beings have been trapped by materialism and a weaker sense of right and wrong. Wars prompted the development of powerful lethal weapons. In reviewing the thousands of years of human history, we realize, in just less than 100 years, there had been two major world wars, which caused numerous killings and tragedies. The abuse of science and technology has also destroyed the ecology, causing damage to the ozonosphere and the unbalance of the climate. The corruption of human beings' minds has called the natural disasters to come. The human has created calamity. God, with His mercy, makes Tao available to everybody in order to save good people. After we receive Tao, with the true meaning of Tao in mind, we will be conscientious. We can use the three treasures whenever something dangerous and uncontrollable happens to us. We will be able to get away from bad encounters. This is a confessed fact. See, transcending life and death. Life is a mixture of happiness and bitterness. Throughout the journey of life, we experience birth, growth, aging, illness, and death. Joys are momentary and wealth is here today and gone tomorrow. Rather than seeking the pleasure of material life, the wise make full use of their lifetime searching the true meaning of life and eternity. In old times, doubt could only be received after harsh self-cultivation. Among the hermits looking for the master in order to receive Tao, only very few could obtain it. Whereas in this century, Tao is allowed to be spread and transmitted through the authorized masters to the truth seekers. The master points out the main gate of life and death, assuring the completeness of our true self. With the true self as our guide, which keeps us away from evil and greed, it helps us think, speak, and act in accordance with our conscience and intuition. Death then becomes the return of our soul to the eternal and peaceful home where we came from. Thus, we will have lasting joy. The achieving sacred beings, the enlightenment of Tao, which reveals the true self, is like the planting of the seed of righteousness and integrity. Through self-cultivation and self-improvement, the nurturing of wisdom, kindness, and purity, it will blossom and produce the fruit of sacred mind and eternal life. In time of overwhelming utilitarianism, Tao is the lighthouse to the truth. Receiving Tao, and then cultivating ourselves, not only improves our own lives, but also gives us the opportunity to better the world. After we receive Tao, we act upon our conscience and care for people around us. We cherish Tao and disregard personal disadvantages. Then we make an effort to spread the message of Tao to the world, in order for everyone to benefit from it. We are devoting ourselves to the work of God, and certainly will achieve spiritual perfection in both this world and the world after life. To probe further, the supremacy of Tao is based on the heavenly decree of God, by which grand masters can perform the passage of Tao. The enlightenment of Tao from grand masters directly opens the main gate of our bodies, which revives our divine nature. It reveals that heaven is not beyond oneself. Instead, one's true self merges into the entire universe. This is the supremacy of Tao. 1. With the heavenly decree, the enlightenment of Tao is extremely profound and marvelous. It cannot be completely expressed by any words of languages. It is not recorded on any scriptures or sutras. It cannot be described by preaching, nor can it be acquired by human intelligence, nor derived from knowledge and experience, nor achieved from gifted talents. Because the above mentioned all have to be created and can be eliminated, which means that they cannot last forever themselves. They all bear partiality and cannot be applied universally. Hence, they cannot surpass life cycles, nor can they reach eternity. 2. The wonder of the effects and omnipotence of Tao is beyond words. It is the wisdom that does not come from learning. It is what we acquire from God and possess intrinsically. It is the same divine heart before the creation of the universe. It is conscience, the holy heart. It is the divine and immortal nature, the Spirit of God. 3. Tao is too marvelous to be described. It makes us know without learning and function without practicing. It is a prior wisdom, perception, potency, and ability. It is not constrained by words or languages. It functions without thinking, intents, or even actions. However, it can create the sky, the world, the human, all beings, and all existences. All these, after being created, still cannot carry on without Tao even for one moment. Tao is therefore called Great Lord of all beings. 4. Without Tao, the stars and planets in the sky wouldn't he have been in order. The sun and the moon couldn't he have illuminated or revolved properly. Then the yin-yang energies wouldn't he have circulated, and, as a result, this world wouldn't he have been suitable for all of us to live in. 5. Without Tao, the five primary elements of the earth, metal, wood, water, fire, and soil, wouldn't he have been balanced and complemented one another, which could have put the entire world in chaos. Mountains would have collapsed, lands would have cracked, and oceans would have dried up. Likewise, this world wouldn't he have been an environment for us to live in. 6. Without Tao, we, human beings, wouldn't he have been able to walk, to see, to hear, to speak, or to move. Our physical bodies would deteriorate quickly into a pile of soil in 100 days. 7. If one really comprehends the effects and omnipotence of Tao, and can practice accordingly and persistently, one can communicate with and be united with God. This is the absolute truth. It is a glory and marvel beyond description. Therefore, it not after death that one becomes a Buddha. It is when one is still alive that one achieves being a Buddha. And to be a Buddha is to revive and hold on to a one's divine and original nature. This is what we benefit from attaining and practicing Tao. What do we need to receive Tao? We have discussed the many benefits we obtain after receiving Tao. Some would wonder why there is so much given to us. Of course, we should realize it comes from God's grace toward human beings. This allows Tao to be spread around the world, especially at the approaching of the worldwide calamity. People with merit and conscientious mind will have the opportunity of learning about Tao and the way back to heaven. It always holds true that people who had the fortune of receiving Tao are derived from the tree of righteous ancestors. In addition, during the passage of Tao, it is required that we make promises to God that day. After we receive Tao, we will keep in mind the true meaning of Tao and put it into action in our daily life. What we speak and what we do will all be based on our conscience. After we receive Tao, we offer help to those in need of it, and do our best to indicate Tao to more people so that they can all benefit from the grace of God. See, after we attain the three treasures, we promise not to tell them to any other person. The three treasures can only be transmitted through authorized masters in front of God. If we reveal them to any person, they become invalid to the person, and we also defy the heavenly decree. All the promises required are reasonable and achievable. It goes with our nature. If we practice and keep the promises, we will be able to become a wiser and a better person. We will become merciful, and nurture the good seed of doubt planted in our mind. One last thing to mention is that one of the reasons we are able to receive Tao is due to the good deeds of our ancestors. Therefore, as we persistently practice Tao, our ancestors will also benefit from it and so will our descendants. As long as you are prepared for the above mentioned, you are qualified to receive Tao, no matter what nationality, race, or religion you belong to. Notes: in order to be exempted from the rebirth cycles, to avoid the ordeal of hell, to alleviate the suffering and misfortunes in our lives, and to be able to return back to heaven after death and enjoy permanent happiness, we have to receive Tao. And the general qualifications are: 1. To be with a compassionate heart, and to be fortunate enough to be born in a time when Tao is available to the public. 2. To have sown the seeds of virtue by helping many people and offering lots of charitable services in the previous lives. This is the divine affinity with God. 3. To have ancestors with beneficences and welfare work as well. 4. To meet the introducer and guarantor who indicate the way to attain Tao to me. It is very likely that, in the previous lives, we did charitable services together, or we celtified together in the same religion. So, in this life, when Tao is available, we can help each other out and practice Tao together again. So time is ripe for Tao due to our divine affinity. V.I. What impact does receiving Tao have on me? As we mentioned before, unlike the old days when hermits had to leave their families to receive Tao through meditation and self-cultivation, Tao, at the present time, can be received in a way that is applicable and conforming to our practical needs. We don't have to give up our lifestyle in order to attain Tao. By the grace of God, Tao is intended to be delivered to the public at all levels of occupations and around the world, rather than being limited to a privileged group of people. The impacts that receiving Tao can have on our daily life are summarized as the following: A. Receiving Tao creates no conflicts with any religions. Tao governs the universe, including all human beings. It existed before the formation of any religions. It is concordant with all religions, in the sense that religions preach the awareness of conscience and the pursuit of the truth. We don't need to give up our religion in order to receive Tao. On the contrary, by receiving Tao, we will have further understanding of the truth. The conscience becomes our ultimate guidance due to the variations of cultures, customs, backgrounds, legislation, and value systems. It is difficult to find a universal guideline for all of us to follow in our daily life. In receiving Tao, the main commandment is to act by our conscience, the true self, rather than by literature. We should be sensitive to the conscience, rather than be familiar with the laws. See, we will voluntarily keep the promise made while receiving Tao. Through receiving Tao, we are not offered conscience or true self, but merely the opening of the door to a wisdom and mercy. Therefore, we restore the heavenly principles inherent in us, and strengthen the power originating from our conscience. There is no external force that makes us keep the promises and commitments that we made when we received Tao. The only force comes from the guilty feelings that result from our misbehaviors, which reduces the mistakes we make. Deep practicing Tao can accommodate our worldly affairs. The fulfillment of practicing Tao and conscientious awareness does not have to be accomplished in a temple or church. It is not required to abandon worldly belongings or relationships in order to attain the ultimate truth. Each individual can still have his/her family, career, and schooling at the same time. As long as we keep in mind the basic guideline, we should have our practicing Tao and getting closer to our divine self. We will make a better world by improving ourselves first after we receive Tao. By realizing the true self and what we are, the feeling of joy comes to us. The improvements on the quality of our spiritual life will affect people surrounding us. By interacting and working together in Tao, we will make the world better with lower crime rate and less pollution. The wish of Maitreya will finally come true to turn the world into God's kingdom and make people all live in harmony. D.I. What can attest the validity of Dao Tao, due to its completeness and generality, regulates the totality of all beings. Many people, after receiving Tao, with their wisdom, faith, and devotion, realize that Tao is the fundamental principle that governs all things. They comprehend the truth of the universe not only through literature, but also through daily living and nature. Their faith in Tao becomes strengthened and they move forward in their spiritual life. However, for people who haven't or just received Tao, Tao can be confirmed through revelations. Anyone who has received Tao with the front door open shall die peacefully. One proof of this is that for those who have received Tao and died, their bodies remain soft and their faces vivid. Since the soul leaves the body through the correct exit, the corpse can actually remain uncorroded for a few days. With the most advanced modern science and technology, It is still difficult to explain this phenomenon. However, it is a fact that cannot be denied. This has happened before in some religions, but very rarely. For people who have received Tao, this kind of testimony is ubiquitous, unless they have committed serious sins and corrupted their own mind. This can prove the soul has reached an ultimate harmony. Me being the superintendent of the things on earth, human beings are nonetheless weak. Since birth, we are subject to unpredictable accidents and natural disasters. There have been many people who encountered danger, used the three treasures with faith, and got away from the danger or reduced the damage to the minimum. Testimonies of this kind are numerous. The above two mentioned are rarely heard of and difficult to believe, but they are the immediate security given by God once a person has received Tao. Thereafter, with each individual as faith, wisdom, and the accumulation of good deeds, one will come to know the truth more and more. It is up to you to experience the value of this treasure. I hope you will have the opportunity to receive Tao, experience it in your life, achieve ultimate perfection, and realize eternity.
Hello,
hi.
Hello, hi. 2点.
Good morning.
早安. 3点.
Good afternoon.
午安. 4点.
Good evening.
晚安. 下午. 3点. 以后. 5点.
Good night.
晚安 睡前或晚上再见 16点
How are you?
你好吗 7点
Fine, Tom, thank you. And how are you?
我很好 你呢 8点
How do you do?
你好吗 用于第一次见面 回答一红 9点
Nice to see you.
很高兴与你见面
I must be going now.
我必须走了。11点.
Have a nice day.
祝你有愉快的一天。12点.
I hope you had a good time tonight.
祝你有个愉快的晚上。13点.
Goodbye dot slash see you.
再见。 14点
Pardon
请再说一遍 15点
Sorry I don't understand
对不起 我不懂你的意思 16点
Please speak slowly
请再说慢一点 17点
Do you speak English?
你说英文吗? 18点
Thank you very much.
非常谢谢你. 19点
You are so kind.
你真好. 20点
You are welcome.
不用客气. 21点
Sorry dot slash I am sorry.
道歉. 22点
Excuse me.
抱歉, 打扰一下, 23点,
that is alright.
没关系, 24点,
never mind.
别放在心上, 25点,
I agree.
我同意, 26点,
that is right.
对, 27点,
it sounds nice.
听起来不错, 28点
That is too bad.
太可惜了. 二九点。
I hope so.
希望如此。三零点。
That is fine.
很好。三一点。
Can you do me a favor?
能帮我个忙吗？三二点。
Please fill in the immigration form for me.
请帮我填入境登记表。三三点。
What should I fill in here?
这里要填什么？三四点。
Please fill in the hotel name for me.
请帮我填旅馆名称。三五点。
Please help me to fill in the declaration form.
请帮我填报税单。三六点。
For house rent, should I go to a U.S. immigration for registration?
租房子需要到移民局报备吗？三七点。
What is the matter?
怎么了？发生什么事了？三八点。
What for?
为什么？三九点。
Where do you live?
你住哪里？四零点。
Can you speak English?
你会说英文吗？四一点。
Are you sure?
你确定吗？四二点。
May I have your business card or address and telephone number?
请给我你的名片或是地址电话，好吗？四三点。
Excuse me.How can I get to this address?
请问到这地址怎么走？四四点。
How much?
多少钱？四五点。
How far?
有多远？四六点。
How long?
要多久？四七点。
Do you have the time?
你知道现在几点吗？四八点。
What time is it?
你知道现在几点吗？四九点。
Is Mr. White at home?
怀特先生在家吗？五零点。
May I speak to Mrs. Brown?
我找布朗太太。五一点。
Could I visit you tomorrow?
我明天能拜访你吗？五二点。
Are you free?
你有空吗？五三点。
Please come in.
请进。五四点。
Please put on these slippers.
请穿拖鞋。五五点。
Make yourself at home.
请不要拘束。五六点。
Would you like coffee or tea?
要喝咖啡还是茶？五七点。
Some more crackers.
要不要再吃些饼干？五八点。
I hope you like Chinese food.
希望你喜欢中国菜。五九点。
Why don't you stay for night?
你可不在这过夜？六零点。
Please stay longer.
请待久一点。六一点。
I hope that you will come more often.
希望你以后更常来。六二点。
You can come visit us anytime.
你可以随时来找我们。六三点。
We certainly enjoyed your company.
和您在一起，我们十分愉快。六四点。
Come visit us again.
要再来拜访我们。六五点。
See you again.
再见。六六点。
We just arrived from Taiwan.
我们刚从台湾搬来。六七点。
May I use your telephone? Mine is out of order.
能不能借用你的手机？我的故障了。六八点。
When you have time, please come over for a chat.
有空请过来聊一聊。六九点。
Hello, sir. Is Mrs. Lee at home?
你好， 请问你太太在家吗？七零点。
I come from Dallas Center.
我是盛唐来的。七一点。
Could I visit him/her?
我能拜访他吗？七二点。
You are our good friend.
你是我们很好的朋友。七三点。
Thank you for your help.
谢谢您的帮忙。
I appreciate your kindness and support.
很感激你的照顾。
Please come to Dallas Center when you have time.
有空请常来盛唐七四点。
Can you come here to study the Buddhist religion?
请来学习礼节。七五点。
Please come here and study the truth when you have time.
有空请来研究道理。七六点。
Today our teacher will talk about the good truth.
今天我们讲师要说很好的道理。七七点。
If you have any questions about Tao, please ask me.
有任何问题可以提出。点七八点。
I greatly appreciate you giving me a chance.
感谢你给我个机会。七九点。
This is our first time to be here.
我们初来此地。
Language is not easy for us.
语言不通顺。
Please help us.
请多帮忙。八零点。
Thank you for your kindness.
感谢慈悲。八一点。
All thanks to the Lord.
感谢上天。八二点。
Could you invite more people to come to our center?
请您多找人来佛堂好吗？八三点。
All of your family are doing charitable things.
你们家都在做善事。
Such people and family will be blessed with happiness and health.
上天会保佑这样的人幸福健康。八四点。
The Lord will help the people who do charitable things because they have merits.
上天保佑善人，因为他们有功德。
The words of practical English of Trip 1 favor KK, DJ, M.
名词
Noun.
善意的行为恩惠。
See, you did me a great favor.
你帮了我一个大忙。二。
Fill in PH.
片语。
Phrase.
填写。
Fill in the blanks with suitable words.
在空格里填上适当的字。三。
Immigration KK. DJ. M.
名词
Noun right parenthesis left square bracket U
移居
Pass through immigration control at the port
在港口通过移民管制站四
From KK DJ M
名词
Noun
表格
See to apply for a job You must fill out a form
申请工作要填表。
Declaration KK, DJ, M.
名词
Noun right parenthesis left square bracket C right square bracket left square bracket U.
纳税品等的申报。
A declaration at the customs house.
报关六
Customs KK.DJ, M.
名词
Noun.
关税 K. 长大写在关。 报关手续。
J.I. paid $20 in customs on the $100 Swiss watch.
我为100美元的瑞士表付了20美元的关税。
As soon as I got through customs, I jumped into a taxi.
而我一通过海关就跳进了一辆计程车。
He went KK.DJ, M,
名词
noun,
租金租费
see right square bracket left square bracket U,
出租的财产是房地产等
I got to pay my rent this morning,
今天上午我必须付房租
VT,
及物动词
transitive verb
租用租入
from
租出
to slash out they rented a cabin for their vacation
他们为度假租了一间小屋
I have rented the house out to a very nice family
我把房子出租给了一户很好的人家。
By
不及物动词
intransitive verb
出租
That's last for this house rent for $800 a month.
这间屋子月租800美元。
This farm rents for $1,500 a year.
这农场以每年1500美金出租。
Registration KK, DJ, M,
名词
noun,
登记、注册、挂靠。
New the registration of students for the course will begin on Thursday morning.
学生登记上这门课将于星期四上午开始。九
Slipper KK, DJ, M,
名词
noun,
有指室内穿的偏厚便鞋、拖鞋。柔软的船鞋
P1 slippers are usually worn indoors
拖鞋通常是在室内穿的 E0
Cracker KK DJ M
名词
Noun right parenthesis left square bracket C
带货前的薄脆饼干没饼干
I am not really hungry, I'll just have some crackers.
我真的不饿，我就吃几块饼干吧。
Certainly, KK, DJ, add.
副词
adverb,
无疑已，必定，确实，用于回答当然，可以。没问题
They will certainly succeed
他们一定会成功
May I use your motorcycle? Certainly
我可以借用你的摩托车吗行一二
Company KK DJ M
名词
Noun
公司商号
See right square bracket left square bracket G
陪伴友情 U 伴侣们同伴们朋友们
See right square bracket left square bracket G
客人们
New Tom works for a computer company
汤姆在一家电脑公司上班。
People are judged by the company they keep.
根据某人结交的朋友便能判断其人了。
Do you expect company for the weekend?
这周末你家有客人吗？一三
Out of order, PH.
片语
freeze
发生故障违反意识规则顺序混乱
Our air conditioner is out of order
我们的冷气机出故障了
The elevator is out of order
电梯出故障了一四
Elevator KK DJ M
名词
Noun right parenthesis left square bracket C
每电梯升降机
Many department stores had both elevators and escalators
许多百货公司既有电梯又有自动扶梯第五
Escalator KK DJ M
名词
Noun right parenthesis left square bracket C
自动楼梯点扶梯
The new store has escalators to carry customers from one floor to another
这家新商店有自动扶梯将顾客从一层楼面运送到另一层楼面一六
Chad KK DJ My
不及物动词
Intransitive verb
闲谈聊天
About slash away slash on they chatted about the film song last night
他们闲聊着昨夜放的电影
VT
及物动词
transitive verb
因口语点点点攀谈与点点点搭讪与点点点调情
upend
名词
noun
闲谈聊天
see right square bracket left square bracket you right square bracket left square bracket left parenthesis plus aboutslash with the often asked Philip to come in for a chat.
他经常约菲利普进来闲谈。一七
Appreciate KK, DJ, VT.
及物动词
Transitive verb.
欣赏赏识感谢感激体会领会茶之
W right square bracket left square bracket plus left parenthesis that her talent for music was not appreciated
她的音乐才能无人赏识
They deeply appreciated his kindness
他们对她的好以深表感谢
I am afraid you had not appreciated the urgency of the matter.
恐怕你还没有意识到这件事的紧迫性。一八
Nudist KK DJ M
名词
Noun
佛教徒点形容词
Adjective
佛教的佛陀的佛教徒的依旧
Invite KK DJ VT
及物动词
Transitive verb
邀请招待
Right parenthesis right square bracket left square bracket hold to he invited several of his friends to the show
他邀请了几个朋友去看表演。二零
Charitable KK DJ Day
形容词
Adjective
慈悲为怀的仁慈的
To
慈善的施舍慷慨的宽容的宽厚的
Towards Charitable Funds
慈善基金
A more charitable person would forgive the boy's errors
宽容扁儿的人就会原谅那男孩的过错二一
Merit KK TJ, N,
名词
noun,
价值 U, 长处优点 C, 攻击功劳 C, 功过是非曲直
Peter's singing is totally without merit.
他的演唱一无是处。
People may not like her, but she has her merits.
人们也许不喜欢她，但她也有她的优点。
She will judge the case solely on its merits.
别人认为我是什么样的人，我自己认为我是什么样的人，我的做事态度是什么样的。好，最后更重要，今天我们要当老板，我们希望有更多的收入，我们希望做想做的事情，那你希望在这样的创业领域当中，你想在什么样的领域成为什么样的人。好，相信在座伙伴都已经写完了，没有写完没关系，我们就再继续看下去。好，接下来大仁哥就要帮你解释一下什么叫做职涯必胜的黄金方程式。首先就是我们刚刚写的这一张名片里面，它就隐含了所谓的黄金方程式。有哪些黄金方程式呢？第一就是我们的专业领域，第一它就是我们的武器，知己知彼，我有哪些擅长的武器，就是你的专业能力，你能够提供的服务，你能够提供让人家觉得品质很好的服务或者是技术，那是什么。再来人格，这个我们在圆梦十二里咨询里面，陈琼华 Robin 老师曾经有提醒过我们，工具不需多，但是要精。在座很多伙伴男，尤其是男性跟我一样啦，大学时候我们常常骑摩托车啊，摩托车坏掉怎么办，我们就会拖去看摩托车行，然后问那个经验老道的 老道的阿伯，对不对，说摩托车坏掉怎么发动的时候过程当中好像有怪声音。你会发现他很神奇的是，他拿过来钥匙电源打开，引擎砰啊，火星塞有问题啦。你会想说，哎，你怎么知道？听就知道啦，因为他修的摩托车太多了，技术太纯熟了，所以连一个声音的改变他都可以知道是哪个部位有问题。所以最后他就跟你讲，修这样2000元，你 不给都不行，对不对？所以技术不用太多，三个就好，最多三个就好，然后要精专精。有的时候常常我们在校园演讲的过程当中，很多学生都会告诉我，老师，我大学四年我都不晓得我会的是什么。老实说这样有一点可惜，因为大学四年如果你觉得我学不到东西，或者是你在学习的历程当中你不觉得我有学到什么专业能力，相同的时间其他的伙伴都已经有学到他自己的专业能力，而同样的时间我们获得的是什么。所以我觉得专业能力很重要。好，第二就是我们讲的人格特质，这个就是我们刚刚讲的，如果你要达到目标你需要的人格特质。比如说刚刚有很多伙伴很积极很主动很热情很好，如果他想要成为业务人员，我们都知道业务人员就是要不怕被拒绝，要主动要积极要诚恳，所以他如果您的写的特质里面刚好就有符合这样的特质，恭喜你，你就有城市的要件，就是你适合做业务人员这样的能力。好，再来，各位可知道这个图案是什么图案吗？在游乐场里面或者童话故事，哦，有一个时，对，很好，这是时钟剑。时钟剑它是一个童话故事，哦，童话故事是这样说的，哦，曾经有一个国家，哦，就是说这边石头里面有一把剑，然后皇宫里面就来跟大家很多村民宣誓说，如果有任何人能够把这把剑从石头里拔出来，那他就可以成为下一代的国王。然后有一个年轻小伙子，小男生，他不明就里就跑到那个地方去玩耍。后来就他开始很神奇的那把剑是什么，很多的勇士很多的大力士怎么拔也拔不起来，这位小男孩轻轻一松松一拿，整支剑就拔出来了，于是他就成为这个童话故事王国的未来的国王。你知道他用什么要件，童话故事是怎么说，为什么这个小男孩可以拿起来呢？因为有一个智者曾经这样说，唯有心地纯洁诚实的人才能够把这把利剑从巨石里面拔出来，然后这个人就要成为这个国家未来的君王，这个叫做特质。看到这里大家伙伴有点偷笑，是没有错，你不觉得现在要成就一个企业主心地纯洁跟诚实是多么难能可贵的事，对不对？是的。所以最后一个，这个也就是最后一个我们要讲的，就是理想抱负这件事情，也就是我们在座伙伴会花比较多的时间。如果在座伙伴你在跟随大仁哥在讲这张名片的过程当中，您我讲到什么你就很快的能够写完，恭喜你，你在你的职涯伟大航道上面已经开始前进。如果你说大仁哥，我在这个写的过程当中我不晓得我的专业能力是什么，我不晓得我人的特质在哪里，我更不晓得我未来创业要走向哪里，没有关系，我们圆梦十二例里面赖恒毅教练有一个提问例里面，你可以好好的去看他里面的影片， 它说明，它会引导你好好的去反思你自己，我到底想走什么样的路，想走做成什么样的人。那我很欣赏一位王一郎老师啊，他也是我们圆梦十二里的一位老师，他曾经在私底下讲过一句话，能不能成功可能操之在他人，但是想不想成功这件事情操之在我。为什么要特别提这件事情？因为我们的理想抱负有可能在实现梦想的过程当中，你会被人家泼冷水啊，那柯林你长这样怎么可能当 model， 我们常常会被这样子冷水泼到，但是那是我们的梦想。我们都知道梦想不能够被取笑，只是在那个情况下大家会觉得你怎么可能会做到这样。我们知道自己有这样的专业能力，我们这样的那个特质，但是我们常常被人家泼冷水，在这个时候我们能不能坚持到底。所谓能不能成功这件事情，就像我们刚刚在看招牌这件事情一样，各位，你觉得招牌凌乱，可是你非打一通电话的时候，为什么在座所有的伙伴，包含线上的伙伴，你选的答案跟别人不一样？那就是你的喜好。能不能成功这件事，比如说餐厅很多，但是我就选这一家，于是这一家因为你的光顾，它的营业额增加了。没被光顾的人，他没有办法强迫你的顾客选哪一家。但是问题来了，你因为别人这样不选你，你就放弃你的创业吗？你就否定自己的能力吗？当然不是。想不想这件事情，我们刚刚讲理想跟抱负，它是我们的梦想。你有多想成功，你多想成为你曾经梦想的那个人。所以我觉得王一郎老师他在私底下曾经有一个很好的动作，在此借用他的一下，他曾经说，当我们人生呈现在顺境的时候，我们可以举起我们的右手掌，拍拍我们的大腿，然后讲了一句好极了 ，yes， 很好。在顺境中，我们要告诉自己好棒。在逆境的过程当中，我们觉得很挫折，我们觉得这世界很灰暗，但是他还是一样举起他的右手，用力拍了他的右大腿，讲了一句太棒了，我正在成长。这个动作只是在提醒自己，我们的梦想我们要坚持。来，我会邀请在座所有的创业的伙伴举起右手，轻轻拍你的大腿，这样当我们顺境的时候，我们要怎么做呢？好极了 yes， 很棒。但是当我们受到逆境挫折的时候，同样我们举起我们的右手来拍着我们大腿，大家喊声太棒了，我正在成长，很好。只要我们有这样的信念，告诉自己我们要坚持到底，我们的梦想才有成就的可能。好，接下来这个方程式是这样子。当我刚刚讲，当你有具备专业能力，你有很好的人格特质，而且你的理想抱负三者连在一起，它都有正相关的时候，它就会呈现我说了你的伟大航道正在前进。那在座伙伴有一狐疑的眼神，那老师学习历程这件事情到底扮演什么角色？学习这件事情很有趣，我刚讲，通常你在连这个方程式过程中，你会觉得原来我的能力不足，所以我必须要学习。我的人格特质不够刚硬，我的人格特质不够柔软，我的人格特质不够纤细，所以我要学习。我的目标不够明确，我不知道我要的是什么，所以我去学习。所以学习这件事情永远为了需要而学习，而不是赶流行去学习。学习永远是为了自己学习，而不是为了别人的期望而学习。好，学习永远是为了未来而学习，而不是眼前短暂的学习。所以当你缺什么，我们 Robin 老师再度的强调，知识就是要知道，而且要去知道去哪里找到。好，就像现在一样，你会发现大人哥很多的讲稿里面都会引用他人的，借用他人没有关系，告知就好，然后会充实我们的生命。所以学习就是补足你的不足，让你的生命能够成长发光。好，这是才是重点。当然接下来我们来讲知彼这件事情。曾经在简报里林志荣老师也有讲到钓鱼这件事情，我非常喜欢，因此跟他借来引用一下。再请问一下在座的各位，钓鱼这件事情，我们在鱼钩上面会装上钓饵，请问这钓钩上面的钓饵是你觉得是鱼我要放那种鱼比较喜欢吃的，还是我们自己喜欢吃的东西？当然是鱼嘛，因为我们要钓的是鱼，不是钓自己嘛。所以钓鱼这件事情是饵，这件事情是要给鱼想吃的，而不是我们自己想吃的。所以改编它原来一个它的简报的内容，其实创业真正的目的应该是我们创业者是不是能帮目标消费者。 做决定。再次回到我们刚刚那个城市、那个街道的那个场景，你会觉得无法选择，因为不知道要选择什么，因为所有的伙伴说乱七八糟，毫无重点，让人家觉得很压迫感，不知道如何选，他有可能放弃选择。如果大家都没有讲，你非得打一通电话的时候，他可以放弃选择。那我们能不能创造一样的环境、一样的氛围，让大家觉得说我帮助你做选择，而且是很好的选择？好，所以品牌是要经得起考验的，品牌要有特色，因为我们自己、我们的品牌、我们的招牌很鲜明。第二，什么叫做利益？也就是站在他人的立场，帮助他们做选择。所以我们要创业的内容是帮助我们所谓的标的消费者，去帮助他们做选择，或者提供他们更好的服务。但是最重要来的，我们的品牌，我们相信在座所有的创业者，你们绝对不会希望我们今天创业的东西就三年五年就这样结束，一定是需要长久的经营，所以它需要时间的证明。如何证明我们的品牌是经得起考验？最近这个新闻非常非常盛行，对不对？食安的问题，为什么这样食安的问题造成我们最近在社会上、人心上很大的恐惧，甚至已经到了愤怒的地步？因为曾几何时，我们从小信任甚至到依赖的那个品牌，原来到现在你发现它并不是在做所谓正当合理的事情。这个品牌我们以为他们成立实验室应该是帮我们去做检验，帮我们去做筛检，让我们得到很安全的环境使用的安全，可是可能因为一些我们为了要盈利，我们为了要赚钱，我们要养活什么样的其他的原因，个人的原因，不是众人的原因，于是他们私心使用了不正当的材料。所以曾经有一个美国诗人常常讲了一句话是这样说的：人们可能会忘记你说了什么，人们可能忘记你做了什么，但是人们永远不会忘记你用你对他们的感觉是什么。所以感觉这件事情很重要。所以在我们的讲座最后的结束前，大人哥想要分享一句话，最后一个礼物送给你们，就是努力很重要，但是选择比努力更重要。创业的星光大道上其实是很孤寂的，你可能要坚持你的品质，你想要坚持你的技术，你想要坚持你的流程，但是你的同业可能跟你说，何必这么努力，何必那么辛苦，我们只要差一点点东西，我们只要稍微的投机取巧一下，你也可以创造更高的利润，不是吗？你受到这样的冷嘲热讽，或者是你真的在那样的过程当中也受挫了，你信心在动摇了，那样的过程当中，你的价值观、你的人格特质就是你最后一道防线。各位想想初衷这件事情，为什么我们要创业？你是真的只会提高很高的收入，想做自己想做的事，你要成为当老板，很多上班族要成为老板，因为他觉得他的环境的那个老板不 OK， 然后有些老板不够诚信，他们的老板不够照顾员工。那我们创业者就要有一个心永远放在心里面，如果你不喜欢你现在看到的老板，你不喜欢你现在看到我们市场上的一些企业的作为，那勉励各位所有的创业者，你要永远记得，当我们实现梦想的过程当中，当梦想实现的那一刻起，我们永远都不要成为那个我们现在讨厌的那个企业、讨厌的那个老板，因为这就是我们的选择，这就是我们的价值观，这就是我们的品牌。所以很感谢今天有机会能够来到这里跟大家分享职涯力这个过程，希望最后一个这样的演讲、这样的分享的过程当中，能够点亮你们人生的新的方向，能够开创未来各位在创业的领域当中一个新的据点。我是张立人，也是你们熟悉的达人哥，今天很高兴为大家分享，到此结束，谢谢大家，谢谢。
谢谢大人哥用短短的30分钟跟一张名片的大小，帮我们介绍了怎么样去打造职涯力、打造个人品牌的黄金方程式。 在青创沙龙举办了这么多场以来，我相信就是会来参与青创沙龙的年轻创业者、年轻的朋友们，其实大家相信都是怀抱着理想，并且非常努力的每一天的踏实在往目标迈进。那青创沙龙在这边非常感谢各位，不管是在现场的朋友或者是在线上的朋友，非常热情的参与我们这段过程，让我们透过学习、分享和互动，能够让大家在创业的路上走得更远跟更稳。那我们也很谢谢来分享的所有讲师，愿意把他们的简报跟知识的精华分享在网络上。各位接下来只需要在网络上搜寻青创沙龙或圆梦十二例，我们会把所有的资料都公布在网络上，让大家自由的取用跟分享。那今天也很谢谢大家来参加青创沙龙圆梦十二例的系列讲座，我们再见。
公活佛就是真，经济是群生照三千公正，无私可达天活，用真经转万事，佛法无边化大千真经，命运出灾消劫除大道尊修身，化世立功八八圣迹，佛圣千真发慈悲，得则群生的光辉，东来紫气展，普渡三曹开庙玄因身下凡师天然中土有缘分，既往开来万八春白阳逢运道显存青红运，以银阳光普照道德阳万方显养运大同家家佛光照灵山如来净观招无师指点路一条千经外典有未闻真经说因由有缘名师会相求开派白羊运佛经说破朦胧云善智于止离苦轮二六十手艺五气朝元一季飞莲花座上会丹持尊者焚罗汉丈六金身照世间祭人请示归依安清明善男女经文物透墨拾遗首诗点化脱苦之学至中康定心成八经奉佛名一切灾殃化作尘道大为天大至尊至贵点灵台应运开泰万象财善智慧朗朗立身行道内外公里正是明天下通古今谁无错过物但敢入善呵呵成过后苦海陶氏农吉公古志心常念福德高和家平安万事和经文虽浅近不可视为顶上云凤清真经脱苦轮心诚前拜诵消灾解厄离苦障逢凶化吉定真强朝气成心念心明神清身不颠万病解灭不缠念经心喉正屈邪除会是安宁福禄甘元亨利真诵此活佛经福慧双增长通此活佛经子孙得安康诵念活佛经功名利禄的平不诵的真经文永世化为吉若为父母送父母得长寿若为王化念亡灵的超生若为亲有求病殃的安全全家老幼同生念老又保安康送念济公真经免灾又消难送的济公真 惊觉悟第一天真经广布十方界诸菩萨同赞曰济公活佛大慈悲为救救六种园林乐人生死生路真诚诵此经不经说经典功德无量福无边老幼康安寿延年向文功德回向给六亲眷属身体健康往生净土给他们离苦得乐请冤生债主和我们共修佛法发菩提心类是前世今世所结冤愿一一回向给我冤生债主家中有本真经可保平安不送此经奉上神桌却保护尔除邪魔奉请南无大慈大悲救苦救难济公活佛慈悲做主时叩首恭请南无大慈大悲救苦救难天然古佛慈悲做主时叩首活佛恩师慈训论道求道所谓地府抽钉天绑挂名哈哈天空空名挂何处人心和天即天绑挂名也什么叫做一贯道一贯道就是时时刻刻都要一贯之你才能够融合在一贯道里面徜徉在一贯道的快乐之中希望你们能够真正投入全心的投入日常生活就是道啊人与人之间就是道道就是自性就是你的自性佛道是在日常生活中的不是来佛堂才有道也不是到佛堂扫地才是道你在家里的一言一行都是道道就是这么自然这么平常所以每个人不论是富贵贫贱不论是大官或是老百姓都有权利来修道道就是路就是理时时刻刻凭着自己的良知良能来做事这就是道平常之中就有道只要你在任何时候任何事都做得彻底那你任何时候就都在行道了每个人都能尽忠职守把自己的本分做好自然就有道所谓道法自然就不受法的约束道在日用寻常之中修道从日常生活做起每个人尽自己的本分去做一切事情譬如做父母的要尽养育子女的责任做子女的要孝敬父母这就是道道无所不在无所不包山有道水也有道日常生活都有道蕴藏在其中在家里为人父做父亲应该做的事为人子做子女应该做的事这就是道不是在佛堂里才有道道本来就在自己身上只是原本不晓得所以来求知道处是有方圆行方处圆活泼玲珑随机应变这样才会有准绳才会圆满有了方针才有目标如果困在茫茫沧海之中没有舵手目标将何处寻呢所以五里就寸步难行个里就是路里路明确才是道 修道要通玄达变，那有固定在某一种方法上的，若只是固定在某一种方法上，那就不是道了。法无定法，能够适用事实，能够因时因地因人而用，这就是道。
location equals UFI.